All right, so we have talked about greens, we've talked about water, we've talked about timing, and now it's time to really get down to consistency. Now, I know this word is thrown around a lot. It's all about consistency is key. I've seen it here and there. I've seen it all over the place. What the heck does it really mean? Consistency in what? Consistency with what? Now, okay, so as you can kind of tell, it's not just about your behaviors, but it's about the way that you think about this process. It's about the way that you think about yourself, the way that you think, and the thoughts that you have that surround fitness, nutrition, that kind of thing, right? That's what it's all got to do, the perspective, the picture that you decide to paint around this. Now, when it comes to consistency, this is what I've found. The consistency not only needs to come day in and out, meaning you do the same thing you did yesterday as you did today, but the consistency that you really, really want to start to create is the one up here. Reframing and redoing all of those different thoughts that maybe weren't serving you before so that they can now serve you better. Now, this is I kind of get geeked out about this, all right? I love psychology and all kind of stuff. You'll see it in the third module here. But when you have a specific thought, right? You ever notice how, like, when you don't really like somebody, they could be eating a sandwich, like doing nothing against you, doing nothing that's really, you know, if some plain Jane, some stranger was doing it, you'd be fine. But say this person that you don't like, you've had this tick about them for a while, they're eating a sandwich, and you're like, look at her eating that sandwich. She just thinks she knows it all. I saw a meme one time like that, and I just started cracking up because it's absolutely true. You have a specific thought about people, and it's kind of all you start to see. Now, how does this play a role in what's going on here? You have a specific feeling about greens. You have a specific feeling about waters. You have a specific feeling about fitness and health and how you have succeeded or failed in the past towards it. Now we need to scramble all that up and change it and create a better consistent pattern of the way that you think. Something that's even keeled, something that's beautiful, something that's awesome, something that serves you, something that makes you want to do it more and more and more. Okay? So, what are the things that you want to start thinking about? What are the different thoughts that you want to start having towards nutrition, towards health, towards fitness, towards whatever goal you decided to have when you started this program? What is it? What are those things that you want to start to have? Okay. Now, I do want to actually talk about your day in and day out consistency. I want you to think about, let's say, a baby. If you are a mom or you're a dad, you kind of get this. You're going to get this a little bit better than somebody else who's not. But you can imagine with me. So let's play along. Ready? So you have a child. Let's call her Sarah. Sarah's a newborn baby, right? Sarah is hungry. Her whole goal is to be fed, to take naps, and to poop. That's it. Easy, right? Easy killed. And so Sarah gets fed at 3 o'clock on Monday. 3 o'clock, and she starts crying, so she gets fed again at 6 o'clock. And then she gets fed again at 9 o'clock. All right, so let's say those are just the 3 times. I know in reality, babies get fed a lot more than that. So let's say in reality, that's what's going on. So Monday happens, 3, 6, and 9. Tuesday's going to happen. When do you think she's going to expect food? 3 o'clock, on the dot, almost exactly. Even without a continual pattern before that, she's going to go right to the day before. And that's how a baby works. That's also kind of how our body works. So for instance, so Sarah's going to be hungry at 3 o'clock, ready to go. If she doesn't get that food at 3 o'clock, it's going to be 4 o'clock, it's going to be 5 o'clock. Her body is now in a mode where it has no idea when it's going to be fed. So what do you think it's going to do with the first meal that she gets? It's going to take it, it's going to store it all, and it's going to keep it for an emergency just in case 6 o'clock comes around the next day and that's when she gets fed, just in case she doesn't get fed again. Creating consistency gives your body a peace of mind. Creating consistency with when you're going back to timing. Now your timing, it's awesome if you do 2 to 3 hours a day, every two to three hours, you're eating every 2 to 3 hours. It's awesome if you do the intermittent fasting, but like I said, in my example, for me specifically, I eat at 1 to 2 o'clock every single day. No ifs, ands, or buts, 1 to 2 o'clock, that's when my body's getting fed. That's when my body knows how to create a program for itself to know how to utilize nutrition and everything it's getting properly, span out the energy. It knows for a fact, okay, I'm getting fed at 1 or 2 o'clock. I'm getting fed at 6 or 7 o'clock. Cool beans, man. I know exactly how much I'm getting each of those times so that I can go ahead And I could span out that energy until 1 o'clock the next day. But then guess what? I expect to be fed again at 1 o'clock the next day. I need to be fed. Otherwise you get really cranky, you get really mad, and then you go into emergency mode. I'm not being fed. What's going on? What's going on? I'm not being fed. I don't like this. I don't like this. And your body starts to freak out. And then it stores it as fat. It stores it as fat for emergencies. And that's why creating consistency is so important. Not only for the mind, for neural pathways, I can get a little geeked out on you. So you have this pathway. I'm gonna go back to that, the thoughts. Same thing with your eating. You have a neural pathway of how things are going. You wanna strengthen the pathways that you enjoy and that serve you, and you wanna weaken the ones and tear them apart of the ones that do not serve you and the ones that actually hurt you or make you go against what you're actually trying to accomplish. You have a specific path that you wanna go down. There's a fork in the road. You have to decide whether you wanna go left or, that's my right, whether you wanna go right or whether you wanna go left, all right? So you need to decide, I have these neural pathways. I can either choose A or I could choose B. When something happens, when a stimulus happens, that's how your brain works. It chooses either A or B. So for instance, you get hungry, you know you're gonna be fed. Or 5 o'clock comes around, that could even be the stimulus. A time frame can come around and your brain is circuiting one way or the other. Your body is deciding to do something at specific times every single moment. All right? Now, if you decide to choose pathway A, because you're making conscious decisions right now, you're not on autopilot. You cannot be on autopilot during any sort of behavioral change ever. It will not work because you'll just go to the old pathway that you used to have that you're trying to destroy. The cool part about this is when you become conscious about decisions and behavioral change, ooh, I'm kind of going into the last module here, but it's important to say here about consistency. Creating a conscious effort every single day and strengthening that new pathway. What's going to happen is not only does this pathway now get strengthened, this one starts to deteriorate more and more. So when that stimulus happens, you can automatically go to that new pathway. That's what you're trying to do. You're trying to really recircuit the brain to go the other direction. So consistency, what that does is it makes it so that time frames allow your body to make decisions automatically, to know what to do with the energy and the fuel that you're using and that you're spending all that time and effort consuming. You're spending all that time and effort figuring out what you need to eat, making sure you have the greens, making sure you have the water. It's really, really, really great if you're eating all the right things, but if your timing is messed up and your consistency is not, if the consistency is not there and you don't have a consistency, it doesn't matter what your body gets because your body's not going to know how to utilize it properly in the most effective way for your body to run for your lifestyle, who you are, what you want to do, and all the things that you want to accomplish. I hope that makes sense. I really, really hope that creating consistency becomes a habit for you. It's going to be a little tough in the beginning, but all you got to do is get a little bit of traction. Start telling your brain, this is the way I want to go. This is the way I want to go. This is the way I want to go. Get off of autopilot. It's very, very easy. The new pathway is kind of easy. It's not that difficult, but be on autopilot's a little bit easier. And that's why not everybody's fit. That's why not everybody's being led astray. Everybody goes on autopilot because they're tired. They have all these things going on and they go on autopilot. And every single time they allow themselves to go on autopilot, they're strengthening the old pathways. Don't strengthen those old pathways anymore. You made a decision. To decide means to cut off, means to make new decisions. All right. So I hope this really helped. Let me know what's going on. Let me know what kind of consistency you want to create about with your life. What kind of new thoughts do you want to bring into this? Creating consistency really honestly allows your body to know what to do with the food that you're spending all the time and effort, all the money, all the investment that you're having, using it consistently, effectively. All right, guys. See you on the next one.